I mean, you can spend your whole life racking up accomplishments and letters behind your name, but at the end of the day, all of that can't save my life.
26 years old and fresh out of Yale Law School, Seun Adebiyi received some sobering news.
When they first told me that I had cancer, it was hard to hear because I had so many dreams, and then on top of that, to tell me I didn't have a match, it just came all at once. So.
Adebiyi is fighting two aggressive forms of cancer, lymphoblastic lymphoma and stem cell leukemia. Chemotherapy can't cure him, so he needs a bone marrow transplant.
Right now, there are 12 million people in the registry, and not one of them matches me.
It's a reality faced by some 14,000 Americans each year. But for African Americans and other minority groups, finding matches is especially difficult. A simple cheek swab is all that's required to be added to the registry.
People of African descent don't know that they're needed as much. Part of it is that they're probably scared and don't know the process and really aren't informed about it.
A recent donor drive in New York City attracted 250 potential donors, but experts say that's not nearly enough. There are some 500,000 African-American potential donors compared with 5 million whites. As a result, 83% of African-American patients do not receive the life-saving transplants they need.
Trying to increase the representation of minorities in the donor pools is really important.
Dr. Luis Isola is head of bone marrow transplants at New York's Mount Sinai Hospital. He says more donor drives, which target underrepresented groups in the registry, will lead to more matches.
This is kind of playing the odds and increasing the statistical chances of everybody to find a good donor.
Adebiyi's mission isn't complete, but he says he's taking the time to appreciate his search for a donor, a search he calls the most challenging thing he's ever done.
I think I've grown more than any other challenge that I've undertaken, which is why I feel blessed and which is why I can still smile.
Todd Johnson, TheGrio.com.